Very good morning to all. Now, today we are going to study about the second chapter of the geography, and that is interior of the earth. Interior of the earth, what is the meaning of interior? Interior means inside, what is there inside the crust of the earth. Okay, so in the previous classes, you have been introduced to rock types. Different types of rocks are there, volcanoes and earthquakes. Answer the following questions on the basis of that. Okay, so we have to answer this. So when earthquake occurs, what happens exactly? Okay, so as you know, when the earthquake comes, so huge buildings and they collapse, and all the water from the sea comes out of that. Okay, so that is the some of the consequences or the result of the earth occurs. Okay, then how are igneous rocks formed? So we have seen in the last last year only, the melting of process of rocks are going on, and because of that igneous rocks are formed. Then what is a volcano? Volcano is nothing but the eruption of lava. Okay, then which materials come out during a volcanic eruption? So lava, then gas, then ash material comes out of the volcanic eruptions. Then in which state of matter are these materials? So these are in the solid, liquid and gaseous state. Are these materials cool or hot? Why? So you have to, so these are answer you have to give. Okay, now one activity is there, boil half a liter of milk. Okay, you have to take half a liter of milk. When the milk comes to a boil, switch off the gas, keep it lid on the vessel. So what we are doing, we are generally in kitchen, we are doing this activity. So we have to boil the milk and keep the lid, okay, on the top of the that whatever the container is there. Okay, so the latter part of the experiment is very important. You have to use your observational skills and arrive at some conclusion. So latter part means after keeping that milk container to cool. No, so we will see now. After 10 minutes, remove the lid, whatever covering we have kept that lid out of, we have to take out. Take it to a side and tilt it. Okay, you have to tilt that container of the milk. Observe what happens. What can you see on the milk? In what form do you see the layer of matter on the milk? So generally, you know that the upper layer after boiling, no, so upper layer becomes thick and all that, and that, what is that thicker layer? That fat is there. Okay, milk fat we can say. So remove this layer of matter, take note of the difference in temperature of this matter and the milk. So what they are asking us to check the difference of the temperature of the milk inside and the layer. Okay, and answer the following question. So when the milk was kept for boiling, in which state was it? It was in the liquid state. When the milk was boiling, what do you observe? When the milk was boiling, so it was the vapors are coming. Okay, then what had accumulated over the lid of the vessel? So on the lid you see some drops of waters are there. Okay, are accumulated. Then tell whether the matter accumulated on the milk is liquid or solid. That is liquid only. Okay, then was it cooler or hotter than the milk below? So whatever accumulated one was little cooler only, that when the milk was boiling. On which other substances can similar experiment can be carried out? So these are some of the example questions. Now geographical explanation. Before boiling, the milk was in the liquid state. After it came to a boil, steam started coming out from it. Okay, so steam. Okay, so whatever the vapors are coming, so they was coming out. After some time, a thick layer of cream develops over the milk. So as we know that a layer comes, okay, out of the from on the upper part of the milk. The temperature of the cream is lesser than the milk below. Thus, it can be implied that the creamy layer cool faster than the milk below it, which remain hot and in a liquid form. A similar process occurred when the earth cooled. Okay, so what they are doing, they are correlated relation between that earth cool down, okay, and similar to that milk boiling. Okay, so they are comparing these two activities. So the scientists unanimously believe that the earth was formed out of the solar system itself. So what they believe that the earth was formed out of the solar system, what we are observing today. So initially earth was a gaseous hot balloon. So according to scientists, the earth was like a gas hot balloon. So it cooled down as it rotated around itself. So as we know that the earth rotates around its own axis and also around the axis of the sun. Okay, so it was a hot balloon, and afterwards what happened, it rotates itself around itself, so it became cooler and cooler. So the process of cooling took place from the outer surface towards the earth's center. So what happened, the outer surface become cooler and cooler, and what happened as in the inside, as a result the outer layer crust, that is called crust, we will come to know about in this detail after in this chapter only, crust of the earth becomes cooler and solid. But as we move from surface to the core inside the earth, heat increases, and at certain depths the interior of the earth is semi liquid means half solid and half liquid, that is called semi liquid. Then man has always been inquisitive about what lies in the interior of the earth. So he was very anxious to know what is there inside the earth. For direct observation of the earth interior has not been possible as yet. So we are not able to see directly the earth inside interior. So through various methods, the scientists have tried to estimate about the same, to make a gather, to collect. Okay, estimate means to collect the information. To infer about this study of the materials coming out of a volcanic eruptions and the seismic waves is most important. So we know that during the eruptions, you see different types of materials are coming out of that. So because of that only the scientists are able to know the what is there inside the crust of the earth. Okay, then matter coming out of volcanic eruptions consists of hot magma, then gases, then steam, and etc. When lava cools and solidifies, igneous rocks are formed. Okay, so because of that, igneous rocks are formed, lava cools down. Through the estimates of the study of temperature, density, gravitational force, and pressure, the interior of the earth was understood. So because of this, this density, gravitational force, and pressure, we came to know about the interior of the earth. For instance, when we go deep into mine, water mines, that where the we are getting this coal and different types of elements inside the earth crust. Okay, so we feel an increase in temperature. The people who are going inside the mine, okay, so they are feeling hot inside that. Similar, the magma coming out of volcanoes from the earth's interior is hot. Such estimations were made by the geologist. Okay. So, several earthquakes occur in various places on the earth every year. Seismic waves are generated. These waves travel through the interior of the earth. Okay, travel interior of the earth. So, we'll stop here. Okay, thank you.